So, things you do when you're broken.
Yeah. It would be wonderful.
Yeah, Saturday, whatever time you tell me. So we all love to hold everything in our necks. And I have been. I've been seeing videos of me, and I'm like,
this that's it. I can't
all the time, it, right? Yeah. So then what happens is this gets really tight, and this gets short.
Well, you know what else?
And this.
This.
Oh, this pulls down wicked. I noticed
this
when
this pulls. So then now, not only do I feel kind of tired, I look in the mirror.
You look tired.
It looks like
yes. Yeah.
So we need to have
I've known
line.
That for a while.
I've been. I know, and I need to be reminded. But it's not only that. Watch our arms.
I don't do that.
Yeah, well, you're like this right now, even though you don't know it.
Oh.
You just take your elbows and always bring your elbows into the rib cage at the bottom of the rib where your thoracic, where the thoracic ends and the lumbar begins, if that makes sense. All right, now just bring your arms down by the side without them rounding, rotating like this. Look at me. Put the hand in more. See the difference?
Oh. Yeah,
right, so a
it.
Lot of people do this. I told her I wasn't recording live, but a lot of I tell people to roll, and this is their arms because we're still trying to make it do what we want or trying to hold on to our tightness when you just actually release. And this is pelvic tilt and length. So, my posture, your posture, everybody's posture is going to be different, kind of, but it's going to be. What our body needs if we just line it up right. Now just come up, breathe in, reach. When you do that, look at my shoulder. Just reach out, reach. The shoulders don't lift, the arms do. And that whole shoulder complex moves, but it doesn't hike up. We're not engaging the trap. We're just lifting the arm. We're not engaging the traps, we just lift. When we reach out. No, actually reach out and feel. Yeah. It's like right where the clavicle ends, about a finger length down. You can feel that's your pec minor. Do that. That's what gets tight. And then that, I think,
and
is what it's
like.
Yeah.
That's
and then
what
your
hurts.
Yeah. So just fly. Now bring your reach out. So you start, you bring your elbows in right at that where the thoracic part, the thoracic spine ends and the lumbar begins. Now your elbows, bring them in, and now bring your hands to your thighs. The outlifting like this, it's outlifting. It's hard.
Yeah.
It's hard to do, but that's a nice correct. So if you're just standing there, there's not a wall behind you. Just kind of do that. But take the other arm out. Remember, it's a reach out and away. Taking your shoulder, the complex moves, but it moves down and out. And then reach around back. And you can feel that pec minor, find it. The end of the clavicle. It's about a finger or a hand width. It's right about in there. You can feel it. You'll know you're on it. That hug. It helps release this whole area. And now this reach out. Go right down to bended knee.
Straight.
Look at your feet. Make sure your toes are up. There's a whole shift of the butt back. The toes can lift.
Jack, come.
The head always. Bend the other knee as much as you can, keeping your shoulders level. Release that upper hamstring. Breathe. Reach overhead. Lift. Lift from that the belly button, which is where the thoracic spine ends and the lumbar spine begins. Breathe. Play with that shoulder. It's loose. It's engaged in the stretch, but it's not hiking up to your ears. You still have length in your neck, the cervical spine. So now breathe. Bend the right knee. Take your right elbow to your right knee. And rotate and stack so that the left shoulder comes on top of the right. Reach, lengthen. Add the arm, you can bring it over, down and around, and then switch right to the other side. Bend the left, bring the left elbow, stack and align your shoulder, breathe, and reach all the way around. So this is a kind of a windmill variation. You can come up from tippy toe, play with it. Nice.
bend your at the elbow and bring that hand into the lower back. Reach around and bind the right side of your left hand. See how much muscle you have to be able to do that one? The rotation comes right where the thoracic spine ends and the lumbar spine begins. I'm playing with the name. Now you can just switch windmill right around, go right and go right to bind. Breathe, reach, lengthen. I have not been able to bind in a long time. It feels good. So take your right hand and bring the this middle part of the elbow. What do you call that? This, your in-bow.
The in-bow.
Take the in-bow to the head. Literally, so it's somewhere on your head, and you're wrapping your hand around. Turn your palm in and grab right under, right at the TMJ, the TM joint. And just pull, breathe. But as you do, push the opposite shoulder to the ground, and there's no change in your torso. Right, breathe in and out. That's just a nice stretch. Now look up a little bit. Roll the chin up, breathe. Go easy, don't kill yourself. If it's really tight, you don't pick up. Switch right to the other side, breathe. Lift, lengthen, align. Nice stretch, look up. If you want, you can even add more pull by kind of. This gets so tight on me too. Especially when I'm having.
Jack, come.
Ooh, nice.
Come.
Well, my neck wants to do a little spasm. So here.
Good boy.
Start with a rotation.
Rotate.
Keep your feet flat. Right, and your head bites. Rotate. So let's windmill your whole body. Okay? You're gonna rotate toward your getting set. Dizzy. It's funny when you start releasing the psoas. That's where the dizziness and the nausea comes from, I think, because it's so tense.
I'm always
not. You're releasing all that
poison.
Kind of all that stuff we hold on to. So here, right? So really work on not hiking your shoulders. Relax and lifting. And flat back fold.
If it's too tight for you, you can open your feet to a plie. And then flat back forward.
Come up. Come to the middle. Hip forward, shoulders back. Let your head fall. Flat back forward. Breathe.
You can go straight leg. You can go bent. You should just feel good. Let your hips move back.
Come up. Four. Still have that. Now come up and rotate towards the other leg. And then out. And here. Yeah. Ooh, go forward. Reverse back. And then rotate and go side.
Stay here for a minute. Take your hands and bring them out. So you're at an angle. Bring your hands out as far as you can that they're straight and engaged. Breathe. And just walk your body around, cross and hands in front or not, and rotate. We'll both get your arms straight, the back as flat as it can be, and then breathe and go the other way. Right? Now I want you to do that, but I want you to walk up to your knee on your leg and just go through the same thing as well.
So I'm going to the right, I'm going to add my left. Coming up, fully extending your hips and your knees for full extension.
Breathe, and then you can reverse it.
You can bend one knee, bend the other, straighten. What's the matter?
I said I confused myself there.
So here, watch. And I'll come up and let's just go 10, 9, 8, 7, nice and deep and big, thick, 5, 4, and then just switch. Punch, pull. 6, 5. Next one we're going to go a little bit faster. 4, 3, 2. Here's our little aerobics one, too, and go 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. You can make it bigger. Switch. Rotate in and away. Really get big movement. Wanna, feels kind of good. Now just do 10, 9, 8. Quick short. What'd that wing do? 4, 3, 2, 1. Now switch. Elbow up. 9, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. Yesterday I did. More weights on my shoulders. I come a long way. That made me dizzy.
Yeah, like.
Oh, who's the boy? Who's the boy? Oh my God, look at him.
Who's the boy?
Look, oh my God, she's moving.
So sorry, I was like, I heard you, my brother, exchange numbers.
And I was like,